Thank you, guys. Beautiful voice. Good morning. On a Monday, the grand jury gets back to work outside of Ferguson, Missouri, as a city and a nation is on edge. Barricades are up, anticipation building for announcement, but when will that come? I'm Bill Hemmer. Hope you had a great weekend. Welcome here to America's Newsroom. Good morning to you.
Good morning, Bill. Good morning, everybody. I'm Martha McCallum. So local and national leaders urging everybody to stay calm when the decision does come down. But as you could imagine, the police have to brace for whatever violence might happen, no matter what the outcome here. At issue is whether police officer Darren Wilson should face charges in the shooting death of unarmed teenager Michael Brown over the course of the summer in August.
So Mike Tobin now live outside the courthouse. He's in Clayton, Missouri. Mike, good morning. The scene has been what there around that courthouse so far?
Well, the scene has been very tense. Lots of anticipation, speculation that the grand jury decision is imminent, will one day be right. But thus far, the speculation has been wrong thus far. In fact, even the notion that we'll get a 48-hour heads up is really an example of reporters filling in the blank. The county prosecutor has said that we will get a heads up without putting a time frame on that. This grand jury operates independent of the police, who are now operating in 12-hour shifts, independent of the school boards, who have opted to close school for today. The grand jury is expected to meet today without any kind of a time frame. If they want to pull in more witnesses, they can pull in more witnesses. If four of the 12 grand jurors determine that the shooting was justified, Officer Darren Wilson does not get charged. Guys, back to you in New York.
What about the evidence, Mike? Will the evidence be released after the grand jury decision? Will we even see it?
Well, initially, the county prosecutor said that in the event of a no true bill, in the event that Officer Darren Wilson is not charged, that all of the evidence from the scene, all of the witness evidence will be made public and rather immediate. Now we're hearing from the judge, Carolyn Whittington, that she never signed off on that. So the county prosecutor will petition to release the evidence in the event that Darren Wilson is not charged. But there's still a couple of steps before it makes it to the public. Bill?
We remain on standby. Thank you. Mike Tobin, live in Missouri, leading our coverage there this morning. Martha?
All of this started back on August 9th when reports came in that Darren Wilson, a white police officer, shot and killed Michael Brown, an unarmed black teenager. A day after that, the city of Ferguson erupted with chaos, looting, protests, taking over the streets there. A total of 32 people were arrested on that first night. It just escalated essentially from there. 6 days later, Missouri Governor Jay Nixon was forced to declare a state of emergency and lock down a curfew in Ferguson. On August the 20th, the grand jury convened as Attorney General Eric Holder landed in Ferguson. Then a week ago, Governor Jay Nixon declared another state of emergency and activated the National Guard ahead of this decision, which we wait for this morning.
We do know the makeup of the grand jury. The panel consists of 6 white men, 3 white women, 2 black women, and 1 black man. That information just released on Friday, right before the weekend. 12 members of the grand jury, 9 are needed by law to indict.
Former New York City Mayor Rudy Giuliani says the burden on those 12 men and women is enormous, and he is not sure in this case that that's fair. Listen.
This grand jury is under incredible pressure.
Right.
Incredible pressure to indict. I feel sorry for these people because they know if they walk out of that grand jury room and have not indicted, they may have created a massive riot in their city and maybe throughout the United States. To me, that kind of pressure is completely inconsistent with the American criminal justice system, and the people who are putting on that pressure should be ashamed of themselves.
That's a really important element to all of this. Mr. Giuliani also made comments about black-on-black violence as it relates to Ferguson. We're going to have more on that coming up a little bit later in the show.
So what do you think of that comment? Did the mayor have a point, or was he overruled? Send us a tweet at Bill Hemmer or at Martha McCallum, and we'll talk to you on Twitter for the next 2 hours. Very heated debate back and forth yesterday during that segment.
All right, more on that coming up in just a moment. So with